shit could get menacing, frightening, find help sometimes.
What is up, guys? Martin Shred here, back for another video for you guys. And today I want to talk to you guys about something that might be very useful in today's trying times that we are all going through, since we are under quarantine, some of us under lockdown, some of us as well. And it was never a better time to apply some of the not necessarily techniques, but some things you should keep in mind to make your daily life a little bit easier and your consciousness a little bit more aware and at ease. So I've been thinking about this, and since the world out there is getting even crazier and crazier as time goes by, and especially if you are living in a dense urban area or even a suburban area, whether if it's in Europe or the United States or anywhere in the world really, there are some things that we can do to improve our lives in amidst all of this chaos that we are going through. So the first thing that I want to talk to you guys about is how you can actually stick to your duty, to your craft. So what I mean by this? Well, you cannot control the world out there, but you have a duty, you have a job, you have something you do, you have a profession, something that keeps you busy, that makes you a living, or basically earns you money. So if that is either being a student, perhaps you're a father, a husband, a wife, a girlfriend, you take care of someone, whatever it may be, your craft, your profession, you gotta stick to it. You cannot leave the people who depend on you behind. So you can control that part of your life. So focus on that, ignore the outside world. And I don't mean being ignorant in the sense that you don't care about what happens. You must be aware of what happens in the outside world. But what I mean is that you should focus mainly on your craft, something that you do, on which people depend on you to succeed, to do well in. Okay, so next I want to talk about the next step that you should take in this trying times. And this might seem a bit controversial, and I'm not 100% in favor of it, but more and more I'm arriving at the conclusion that this might be a necessity. Of course, more or less depending on where you live, but what I'm talking about is getting ready to defend yourself, so you can defend yourself in case of an attack to your property, to your home, to your house, or maybe out in the street. Because the times where we could freely go out and just walk around, those are sort of coming to an end. Like those times that we used to see just strolling around as completely secure and safe are not necessarily happening today, especially if you're one of those countries where riots are happening back and forth between all types of people among densely populated areas. And so there are some steps you can take in order to prevent this threat that goes upon you, upon your loved ones and your family. So if you have, for example, a shooting range near you, how about starting some new shooting range, some classes, some orientation? Maybe if you're in a country that allows properly guns, maybe you should seek out and maybe try and give it one or two shots. Maybe you already have guns at home, but you don't know how to use them. Now would probably be a good time to actually practice, because you never know when someone's going to rob you. And especially in today, I speak for myself, I have been a victim of theft in my own properties. I was stolen tons and tons of merchandise in the forms of either cattle or even food, as in fruits from the trees I grow, from the plants that I take care of. And it was right under my nose. And of course, I don't mean necessarily get only a gun, but how about some self-defense classes where you can defend yourself if you don't have any weapon with you at that particular moment? Or even invest in security systems for your house, whether it be improved fencing, a night guard maybe, some direct contact with the authorities in case someone breaches your property. Just something to think about, guys. Just something to think about. And trust me, you don't want to get robbed like I did. And last but not least, I want to talk about what you can actually do in the vicinity of your own home. Imagine if tomorrow the world just came to an almost complete shutdown. For example, in the other day, I think it was maybe on past Monday or Sunday, I don't know, YouTube actually went down, and it went down for a lot of people around the world, and that actually made people freak out around the internet. That's what I actually noticed when this happened. And what did that make me think about? That was only one website that actually went down for a couple hours, maybe at most, or maybe a day at most. I don't know for sure, but anyway, there was just one website. Now imagine if they actually pulled the plug or just hit the kill switch on the whole of internet. You and I both know that this is possible. If the people who control this want to do it, they can just easily go on their control panels and just hit the kill switch. And in that case, what are you going to do? Your cell phone is as good as a brick, because you won't have a cellular reception, you won't have internet, and in this case, your friend or your relative that is on the other side of the country, or even about 2 or 3 miles from you, is about as good as being on the other side of the world. It doesn't matter, because you cannot reach him. You don't have a way to communicate with him in case disaster happens. So what you can do is actually try to be part of a hyper-local community. And what I mean by this is that you should get to meet your neighbors so you can establish some sort of healthy relationship, so you can discuss your strengths and weaknesses and arrange some sort of closed family, so to say, in order to go through some event like this catastrophe, where I can collaborate together. And if it does happen, the closest people to you are the ones, for example, in your neighborhood, in your apartment building, in your area, because those are the only people which you can actually talk to and communicate, because you don't have cell phones, you don't have internet, assuming that you don't have any of these things. And I'm not even talking about electricity. So just think about that. Get to know your neighbors, get to know them, get to know their strengths, their weaknesses, how you can work together if such a thing happens. Get familiar with them and actually devise some sort of plan, some sort of backup plan in case something like this happens, so you can all be prepared and take the appropriate measures to actually mitigate this event. By now you have probably noticed that I am out of my usual shooting videos room where I usually do them, and I actually decided to get in the car and do a trip to the countryside where I can go ahead and do some work, some videos for you guys, and just do a little change of scenery for, you know, not to be too monotonous with the sets and what I'm aiming for on YouTube. So I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you're all staying safe. I hope this video was helpful to you in any way, shape or form. And if you have any questions, if you want to discuss some of these ideas down in the comment section, you are more than welcome to do so. I hope you are subscribed. If you are not, be sure to subscribe for more videos like this. I maybe will be going for a more vloggy style of videos. I don't know, maybe I'll do a mix of both. I'm just in a phase where I'm experimenting with different ways to shoot and produce content. So if you like this video, be sure to subscribe and stay tuned for more, guys. Until then, stay safe. I'm Martin Shred, and I'll see you in my next video.